power of sites in mWater. mWater allows you to collect any data you want relating to water, sanitation, hygiene, and beyond using surveys. But whenever you're tracking any location or facility, we recommend that you use sites. This makes it easy to monitor data over time, and it also makes it very easy to come back to the site you've mapped before. Once you have created the site once, it will show up in your app when you go back into the field. Importantly, you can link sites and surveys together. That allows you to see information about both at once, see baseline, midline, endline, and monitoring visits, all linked to the same site, and also saves you effort when you don't have to collect the same data about the site over and over again. Here in the map, we can see that many people are already using sites to track water points and water systems in this example in Uganda. How do sites work? Sites can be created in the app. They form points on the map in the world, and they are not limited to water points. They can be schools, they can be health clinics, they can be other institutions, communities, water systems, and so on. And because they can be linked to surveys, you can then come to these sites, link any survey you create to them, and keep doing that. Then when you build analyses, maps, dashboards, and consoles, you can show all of that data linking to the same site in one place. Let's take a look at how this works. Here is a dashboard just showing a couple of sites captured in mWater with many surveys linked to each site and the surveys tracking water levels by month. So these are four different surveys linked to each site, and this chart shows the average of both. In this dashboard, I can zoom in to and filter down to the individual water points, so we can get very easily and powerfully this tracking of data over time by these four survey responses, which have all been linked to the same sites. This is what we want to get to. Now let's go and create a site. I open my mWater Surveyor app and I choose to add a site. I choose out of the options available. For this example, I choose Water Point. I shall make it public. For privacy settings, public means the site is visible for everyone and editable by everyone. Protected means it's visible for everyone but editable by only you and your organization. And private means it's only visible to you and your organization and only editable by you as well. We give the water point a name and we select the location. I know I'm here in the field, and I know there's a well here. So I select the location, I can add a photo, choose the type, for example, set it as a protected dug well. If I want, I can link it to a community, link it to a water system, and so on, adding to the power of sites. I shall create the site, and now I can start creating surveys on it. I will start my water level survey. Let's take a quick look at the survey. I've designed this survey, which very importantly has a site question type. This allows me to link the question and the survey to the water point. Then it asks for the measurement date and the water level. Now let's imagine I was visiting this water point back in December, and then it was 4 meters. I'm now filling in my survey, but it is linked to the site. So I'm combining the two. I'll create a few more. Let's say I have left and I come back. I open my app. I see that my water point is now visible in the app. So I can walk with app in hand and find exactly the site I'm looking for. Very convenient for enumerators. Now I come back in January, let's say, add a survey, and discover that there were 6 meters of water level in this example, and so on. I can also start from the survey water level and select the site from there. So I can either start from the site or start from the survey. Now, this is the last piece of data I'm entering. 5 meters was what I discovered. Then I go back to my app homepage and synchronize my data. We refresh the page with the dashboard, and now we see we've added the water point site, and we see the average of water levels has changed. And now we can zoom into our new water point and see, in December it was 4, in January it was 6, and in February it was 5 meters. So this can be extremely powerful and save you a lot of effort. So whenever you are collecting site data for any location or facility that you want to come back to and you want to track over time, strongly recommend in mWater you use Sites. There's more written guidance in the video notes.